Hookah Chef back here. Today I have another tobacco review for you. It's actually over Hookahfina Blak Absolute Mint. They've definitely done a lot of new things with the new Hookahfina Blak line. This is batch number 3, and they've changed up the cut a little bit, and they've definitely changed up the liquid around it. I know a lot of people used to refer to this as Hookahfina Green due to the stain that it would leave your hands, kind of a weird, nasty looking green. But now it's back to brown. The cut on this is super juicy, comparable to Famari almost. And it's super fine. It's almost like they ran it through a blender. But the smell coming off this, it is a very strong mint. As soon as you open it up, you're gonna get a super mint smell. I guess after this, I'm gonna go into the smell a little bit more, and I'll go into the taste. To kiss the ones you... Alright, so as soon as you get this, it's actually going to come in a package that looks similar to the Tangiers packages. So I just put it in a shallow Tupperware container straight around. It doesn't need acclimation or anything. I just like to keep most of my tobacco in the containers. For a better close-up of the actual tobacco itself, you can see it there. It's super juicy, super fine cut. And the smell, you get kind of a variety of mints in there. And you really get a strong tobacco undertone. One of the most dominant mints in there is the peppermint. I definitely smell some like fresh mint leaves, like the sweet mint, but I really get a strong peppermint smell. And I guess I'll go into how the smell goes through to the taste. So for the setup today, I have my Elma 618 hookah, a Heba diffuser, aluminum D-hose, the apple on top with the Provo system, and two titanium coals, flats, and alright, I guess let's get into the taste. Alright, you get out of the way. Come here. My dog's blocking the view. So, the taste is exactly how it smells. You're going to get a really strong mint. You definitely get the sweet mint and the peppermint. And there's almost a cooling effect of some menthol, I want to say. It definitely hits you in the back of the throat at first. This might be too strong if you're not used to really strong mints. So you might want to let it sit for like 5-10 minutes before you actually take your first few hits. Other than that, you do get a strong tobacco note. And that's due to the high nicotine content, I think. This is actually supposed to be a high nicotine line, but for me, being a very average smoker, I smoke daily 2-3 bowls a day. I don't get too big of a buzz off this, if any at all, really. So if you're not used to nicotine as much as I am, be careful. But as you can see, it puts out really good clouds. Big white fluffy clouds. I haven't had any problems with this burning. So I don't think it's really heat sensitive. Other than that, it's lasted the entire round of coals. I've had it in the AOT before and it's lasted 4.5 hours for me. Full flavor the entire time. Around the 4-hour mark though, the menthol kind of died out and all I got was the peppermint, but I wasn't complaining. If you're not a big cane mint smoker and you just don't like that version of peppermint, I would definitely suggest trying this. It's definitely a really nice peppermint. It's a lot sweeter than cane mint, and it definitely leaves that coolness in your throat. I thoroughly enjoy it. I picked this up at 5starhookah.com. If you want to pick it up from there too, use the discount code HE15. And I guess, tell me how you like this video. Do you like it, Hachi? Hachi! He says he likes it. So, it's Hachi approved, and I'm gonna get out here, finish the session, watch some TV. So, before I go, I actually want to show something to y'all. I'm actually gonna give you kind of a sneak peek of what my next review is gonna be over. As some people on Hookah Enthusiasts like to call it, the Insta-Done Bowl. It is the new Glider Bowl. It is actually a new bowl that hasn't really hit the market quite yet, and it actually has a little tobacco drawer. Definitely different. I'll get more into that on the review of it. So, I'm gonna get out of here. Let y'all Keep smoking.